cut out of our Abels, and this is my presentation on my final project. For my final project, I drew an engine for a car. I ended up with 49 part drawings and 20 assembly drawings. When I started this, I did a comparison between a whole bunch of different engines. Took V6 engines mainly from GM, Ford, Toyota, Mercedes, and Honda, and I compared it, and I also threw in two four-cylinder engines because I wanted to compare the efficiencies between V6s and four-cylinders. Part I had the most problem with is what you see there. That's the head of the engine. I did not have that many dimensions for this part. Because of some things I added to this set. I have basically something similar to this at home, but it changed a lot as I started drawing it. I needed two of these. I needed both the left and the right side because I did a V6, something I didn't think about before I started doing this. It's a good idea to think about that. Part of that reason is the heads are really different. Places where the valves are the cylinders are staggered, so one head is, the cylinders are in different positions than on the other head, so it won't bolt up, it won't line up, it just doesn't work that well. I also, when I was drawing it, I forgot that there are bolts that go through the head and not just a block. So I ended up drawing my cam supports over where the head stud should go, so I had to come up with a pretty fun solution for that. I ended up drawing this three times. One, because I just screwed up and had to start over again. The second reason was because the computer just destroyed it. When I went to open it, the pro engineer came out and nothing would be there. I just shut off right away. You know what I'm talking about.
Yeah.
These right here are blends. These were particularly hard because they started as one, and then this is the intake side. I decided to make a 5-valve head, which also made my life harder, because this side had 3 valves, and this side had 2 valves, so I couldn't just mirror it over there. That's why you see this angle and this angle. But anyways, like I've seen before, this is one entrance here, and it breaks down to two. This is two. So what I ended up having to do is I started with one, blend, you don't know how that works because you have to have the same number of vertices as you go through your blend. So what I ended up doing was I faked it. I left a little gap, but it was really small, and I only extruded it about this far in, and then I only cut out about this much, and then I just extruded cylinders going into the valve area. You can also see valve areas here. It's a good time. This was my solution to forgetting to put head studs in. You see here, this is where the cam goes. Two cams, cam engine. But here, that's where the head stud should go. So I sort of gave myself a little trouble. This was originally one big solid chunk. My solution was I cut it in half. So I could take this off and put the head studs in, and then I put these holes here, and here, and that secures, it sort of sandwiches the bottom piece, the top piece, and the middle piece together. And it actually worked out for a chain. And that was cool. And this was my idea for changing the lift of the valves, just, put a little hard-mounted cam over there. I don't think that one of these would be such a great idea, though, after seeing what some of the motor companies do. That top one right there is actually Honda's design. That's their little V-tech. These are what I ended up going with. This is what everybody uses to vary the timing, from Porsche to Honda to everybody. That's what they use. And this is Toyota's little variable lifter mechanism. I ended up having to change it because this is way too deep for my head design, and I just had to move some stuff around. Which, is. Actually, I think I have the plans here. Oh, wow. That's not how I originally had it. Well, behind these two shots here is the nice exploded view of the campway. But you can see these two pieces here. You can see here there's a shaft that comes through. Fluid comes to the shaft in here, pushes this, which stops this from going down. This is what the cam load is. Now, normally what will happen is under normal driving conditions, this load, the tall load, will end up hitting this this here, and it'll just, the spring will keep it from actually forcing the lifter down until you want it to engage, in which case it will push the lifter farther down, which gives you a greater, gives the valve more, pushes the valve down farther, which keeps it open longer, which is much more. Yeah, I didn't have my cute deep drawing example. I have a video on my website, which I'll get. But in conclusion, I realized that there's never enough time to do a CAD because it takes so long, and there's always so much detail.